What's going on, guys? Welcome back to a brand new video. Today, we'll be going through some of the squads that you guys sent me through on Twitter. Now, these are your squads that you guys have sent through. Maybe it's a bit of a cheeky flex. Maybe it's for a bit of advice. And in no way am I the best player in the world, the best my team player by absolutely any stretch. But it is always good to get advice or even just flex your lineups a little bit. So if you guys didn't see the tweet, you can see it below and you can see it next to me that I put out a tweet a few days ago asking for you guys to reply with a screenshot of your team, and we'll be going through a few of them. There's a few of my DMs as well, which I'll also be going through. So make sure if you did send them through or you did put them in the tweets, the tweet that I tweeted out earlier, make sure you keep watching this video. And if you didn't end up sending your lineup through, make sure you comment down below which one do you think is the by far the best. And I have a few ideas of who might be the best. Alrighty, first up we have Bihar, and if you've been in my Twitch streams, you know that Bihar loves to come in and pretty much just bully me all the time. But this is Bihar's lineup. You can tell that the man is an absolute grinder. You can also tell he's got quite lucky with this Miles Turner center here, this glitch market Miles Turner. Now, the one thing that I'll say about this lineup, obviously there's an Emerald LaMelo Ball, but the one main thing I'd say is that Paul George card. Paul George is someone I've never been able to get. I got him from the locker code recently. I play with him a little bit. I've never been able to get good with him. Maybe he works really well with Bihar. I've never actually played against Bihar. I probably should soon. But this lineup, obviously, Jordan, John Wall is one of the best point guards in the game still. Good old Terry, one of the best reward cards we've been given. AD is still good. Like, he's quite an older card in terms of right now in the game, but he's still very, very relevant. And obviously, Miles Turner, that glitch card, is absolutely amazing. LaMelo, I think he's a big fan of LaMelo. Brandon Roy is a card I really wanted to get. He's a card that I want to kind of get. I've always been a fan of Brandon Roy and his jump shot. Wes is a very, very good player. Interesting enough, where's that power forward? That's something that I've seen a lot of people playing him center. He is capable of playing a power forward, obviously, with the height. And Kevin McHale is a card that I've never played with, but I've had a lot of people play against me with. So overall, I'm not going to do ratings because I don't want to be that sort of like, I don't want to give that kind of cocky rating. But this is an amazing lineup. Bihar, you're a grinder, mate, and keep it up. All right, the next one we have here is Gabe, who is a future metal winner. I can already tell this dude is going to sweep the competition for the next few years. He has got Magic, Vince, Scotty, AK, and Jokic to do starting five. These are disgusting top five. I love that. I love that lineup. That AK is so frustrating to play against. If you've played against him, you know, especially in a five format, if he gets open, he is going to drain that shot. And Jokic is one of the best centers in the game. Don All is a point guard that I run. I think Gabe knows that I run that card. I absolutely love Don All. Andrew Wiggins, I've never used, actually. Dumas is one of the, he's a recent card, but his jump shot is so nice. Julius Randle, very, very nice as well. And that Cat card is also very nice. So Gabe has put a lot of time and effort into auction bidding. He's done a lot of MT grinding and stuff like that. And obviously it is paying off with this lineup. It's a very, very nice lineup. By far, that AK is my favorite card. All right, now it is time for Murray. He's got a very, very similar lineup to a lot of the guys from before. He's got John Wall, Wilkins, AK, Mel Daniels, and Nikola Jokic. Now, that Mel Daniels card I will be doing a gameplay of over the next few days. But once again, AK, he is unstoppable. I absolutely love him. And Dominique at the shooting guard, very, very smart to put him at shooting guard. Has that height advantage of a lot of those smaller shooting guards. Maybe people play Donovan Mitchell at the two. Things like that will overpower those cards very, very well. Rajon Rondo is one of the most glitchy players in this game. If you get a wide open lane, he will dunk nearly over anyone. For the height that he is very, very good. Brandon Roy, obviously, I love Brandon Roy across 2K. I said that before. Billy Cunningham, I've never actually used. I was unfortunate I didn't get him across the Ascension boards. Julius Randle, love him to death. And Dirk Nowitzki is a fantastic center as well. So, especially that John Wall card. You guys know I love that John Wall card. I was unfortunate I haven't got him myself. I haven't gone and grinded. I know Murray himself, he's a very, very big grinder of my team. So, props to Murray. You guys know that I use his account sometimes to do some reviews. But this lineup is very, very nice. It is one of the best that we've got here, especially that Mel Daniels card. I know that he has it evo'd now, which makes it even better. Alright, next we have Mr. Big L Jeffer, also known as A-Train. This guy has a phenomenal lineup. Look at the centers on this team. Wilt and Kareem on the one team. Imagine having Kareem as your backup center. That is just phenomenal. Obviously, Kevin Durant is one of my favorite cards in the game, if not my favorite. I absolutely love that card. Clyde Drexler, very, very glitchy. The only thing I'd recommend, unless, I don't know if Jeff is under Mr. A-Train's watching this, But the only thing I'd recommend, if D'Angelo Russell, unless you're an absolute god with D'Angelo Russell, I would maybe recommend him being the next spot that you replace, unless you're an absolute god with him. The only reason I say that is because if we look at Murray's lineup, where there's Dominique, kind of like if he happened to have Dominique playing against against D'Angelo Russell, he's going to be able to blow by him a lot, because that D'Lo isn't as good at defense as a lot of recent shooting guards that have come out. So that would be my only like critique of this. I don't like critiquing, I hate doing that, but like the D'Lo card never works for me. It might work for A-Train, and that's completely fine. But if I had to make one change to this lineup, and by the way, that Danny Green card, I love it to death. And Luka is still, he's like an AK that can dribble really well. I love Luka. I hate playing against him. But that's probably my only suggestion, is that D'Angelo Russell card, it's never worked for me. It might work for him. It might work for you. If you're watching, you've got that D'Lo card. But for me personally, he'll be a card that I'll get rid of. Alrighty, here we have Rai, who has said, this is everything I have. Not looking to grind for anyone, as I'm going to mainly switch to MLB. For now, I'm looking to replace KPJ and Latrell. Any suggestions would be amazing. Now, for me, first off the bat, that Yuta card, the Yuta card's got it very, very nice. Very nice base on his jump shot. It's a very nice jump shot overall. But as I said before with A-Train's lineup, unless you are strictly an absolute god with Yuta, there's a lot of cards that are around a good price. Like, I know that you got 144k here. You could buy Tyrese Haliburton, right? Tyrese Haliburton is a top 5 point guard at the moment. I don't care what people say. Tyrese Haliburton, he's a diamond, but he's a top 5 point guard right now, and you could definitely put him in instead of Yuta. Completely your choice. If you're a go with Yuta, then absolutely do that. Latrell's a nice card. I still like Latrell a lot. There's definitely some small forward out there. Dominique, maybe look at investing in a Dominique. He could be a backup, or even kick Zach LaVine to the bench and put Dominique as your starting small forward. Things like that. Definitely have a look around and have a look at a lot of the recent small forwards, especially with this MT. You can do a lot of swapping and a lot of flipping of cards, and make sure, yeah, it's really just upgrading as you go, finding cards that you'd like and sticking with them. It doesn't matter if they're an Amethyst, Diamond, it doesn't matter. If you're good with that card, stick with that card, all right? It is as simple as that's something I live by. And the Maxi Cleaver, maybe look at upgrade Maxi as well. But besides that, very good lineup, Rai, and just keep grinding, man. I know you're going to be playing MLB, but keep grinding, this my team, man. Alrighty, and here we have Alpha Wolf. I'm trying to speed through these as fast as I can. I know I've gone on way too long with a lot of these. This is Alpha Wolf. He's got Luka, fantastic, Steph Curry, Brandon Ingram, Paul George, Karl-Anthony Towns, Frank off the bench. You guys saw my video yesterday. You guys know my opinion on Frank. Jerry Sloan, I haven't had a chance to get my hands on him yet. Zach LaVine, Miles Turner, and Nikola Vucevic. So we can tell that Alpha has been absolutely grinding this game. He has got 2 glitch markets. I knew that he had 2 glitch markets, managing to get Miles and Frank there. He's also got 3 off the bench. I never really considered a 3 off the bench at the 11, 12, and 13. But overall, like, I mean, Paul George, as I said before, it never really works for me. If he works for you, that is perfect. The one thing that worries me about this lineup is having Steph Curry at the shooting guard position. Because as I said before, if you have a tall shooting guard, or even even if you had a Brandon Ingram. See, Brandon Ingram can play small forward or shooting guard. If your opponent is playing, if you're playing a man-to-man and you've got Steph Curry defending Brandon Ingram, he's not going to be able to defend him that well, because Brandon Ingram, he's what, 6'7", 6'8", he can dribble very, very well. A lot of those taller, small forwards that can play shooting guard as well, Steph Curry's going to have a lot of trouble trying to defend him. But besides that, love the lineup, Alpha Wolf, keep grinding, man. Alright, and here we have Isaiah with one of the best lineups of the day. We have Magic, Michael Redd, he's been grinding. He's got that Michael Redd. PG, that's a better version of PG. Julius Randle, Kareem, Tyrese Haliburton, top 5 point guard himself, Jerry Sloan, Richard Dumas, Sidney Wicks, and Kevin McHale. As I said, I've never really used the Kevin McHale. I don't know what he's like. I joined my team too late to get him. But the Kareem, obviously, Kareem is a phenomenal card. Julius Randle at power forward is much better, in my opinion, than having him at center. So a great choice there. Paul George is still one of the best wing players in the game. Michael Redd, I'm grinding to get that Michael Redd. I'm very, very excited to get him. And Magic is such a great point guard. So Isaiah, you have an absolute phenomenal lineup here, mate. There's nothing I can critique here. It's a phenomenal lineup. Keep going, man. I'm going to try and rush through some more. I might have to do a second video, but I'll try and push as many as we can. We had about 20 submissions, but we'll try and keep going through more here. Alrighty, and here is JBTTN's lineup here. You can see he's got John Stockton, Zach LaVine, Malik Sealy, Kerman, and Mark Eaton. And his bench isn't set out how normal, like a lot of other players. I didn't mean to say normal, but a lot of players have their team set out how they'd have their point guard, shooting guard, small forward, etc. But never mind, as long as you know how to run your lineup, you know how to run your lineup. Initially, the one thing I would replace, it's similar with kind of how AI is this year. John Stockton, the AI, just basically too small, especially that John Stockton, the glitch one. He has a 93, but they're just too small and they can't really dominate as much as a lot of point guards recently. I would make the suggestion, once again, I know the MT's not there necessarily right now, but if you sold a few of the cards, maybe picked up a few heat check cards, sold them when the market is booming, maybe you could pick up a Tyrese. He's going for I keep recommending Tyrese, but if you like your diamond cards, you like those cheap budget point guards, highly recommend Tyrese. He's got a wet jumper, he has great dunk packages, and he would be a big upgrade over the John Stockton. All right, and here we have Daddy Okumpo. I know that's not his real name, but this is his lineup. He's got Don All, Terry, AK, Kermit, and Jokic as his starting five, with Donovan, Clyde, Billy, and Spencer, and DeMarcus coming off the bench. Now, there is not a lot of like recommendations you can make straight off the bat here. Maybe if you play with cards personally, you don't like it, like me with Frank and Nilakita. There's different things like that. However, the only thing I'll say for you, Daddy Okumpo, I'd say I can't say that name with a straight face. But the only thing I would say is to find a card in this lineup you don't enjoy and upgrade that position. Like maybe you don't like DeMarcus coming off the bench. Maybe you find a better center to come off the bench. Maybe you invest. I know there's not a lot in the MT at the moment. Maybe you put a few diamond contracts. I can see there you got a diamond contract on Clyde's. I'm assuming there's a few diamond contracts on these guys. Go into Triple Threat Online and grind that, because you can get so much MT if you play with diamond contract players, because you don't have to invest in contracts and you don't have to purchase any contracts. So you can just grind it for hours at a time and get so much MT off it. So that's the only thing I could recommend about this lineup, is find the card that you'd like the least and upgrade that guy. Alrighty, here we have spammings as well. We got Magic, Malik, Sealing, AK, Mel Daniels, Pau Gasol, Lonzo, Wiggins, Dumas, Jamison, and Sabonis. Now, there's a few cards here that have been recommended myself to use, especially this Lonzo card. I know Gabe and a few others in the chat have been telling me to get this Lonzo card. Haven't used him. Maybe he's a bit outdated now. I'm not sure. I could still pick him up and have a look. For me, personally, I love AK, as you guys have said. The only thing I don't like is Pau Gasol, and there's one reason. It's because he's too slow for me. In transition, getting back on defense, especially me playing a zone, I'm not sure what defense you play spamming, but for me, personally, him getting back, he always leaves that center trailing. So say you're playing against a David Robinson who has a high speed, or you're playing against maybe even a Mel Daniels at center, they're going to be able to stretch out that fast break, and that center is going to outrun Pau Gasol 10 times, like 9 times out of 10. That's my only reason that I got rid of him from my actual lineup. His jump shot, his offense is perfect. If you're a goat with him on offense, and by far just keep him on the lineup. But these, my only recommendation is maybe look at swapping around this center positions, and maybe try to pick up a better center. 25k MT, as I said, go into that game, go into Triple Threat Online, grind out some MT, and maybe look at upgrading him. Once again, if you like him, that's fine, but that's my only recommendation for this lineup. All right, and here we have Air Snags lineup. He's got Donovan, Dantley, Larry Bird. I love that Larry Bird card. He is phenomenal, but he's a pain to play against, I'll tell you that much. Julius Randle and Hakeem as he's staying lineup with the Diamond, Luka, Zach LaVine, Wiggins, Draymond, and Maxi Kleber. Staying lineup is perfect. That is a fine lineup. The only one I'd recommend maybe upgrading is Donovan Mitchell, but if you like, he can work in any lineup. He's a very, very good card, especially for a free card. The only thing I'd recommend is maybe upgrade the Luka and the Maxi. Those key three there are fine off the bench. Draymond can hold himself against 1-5. Wiggins, I haven't used him personally, but he's a very, very nice card, especially when I play against him. And Zach LaVine is obviously really good. The only thing I would recommend, maybe 20k MT, level 28, you're going to get a lot more MT as you go through. Maybe the only thing I'd recommend is upgrading Luka and Maxi Kleber. Alright, and here we have Dragon Gohan. You can see his lineup here is Tyrese, love him, Clyde Drexler, Kawhi, Richard Dumas, David Robinson, Don All, Jerry Sloan, Lionel Simmons, Wes Unseld, and Charles Oakley. He's also said he's no money spent. He's got 1.5 million MT and wants to replace Jerry Sloan and Charles Oakley. Now, initially, with that much MT, you could definitely look at investing into a Wilt or a Kareem, but with a lot of content coming up very, very shortly, maybe save it, keep loading it up, and look for any centers that come out. Definitely, mate, like, I don't suggest opening packs with MT, but if you see a center that you'd like and is absolutely goated, definitely worth picking up. I haven't used that Charles Oakley. I'm not sure if he's good personally. Jerry Sloan, he works for some people, but if you do an upgrade, obviously that's your choice. There's a lot of good shooting guards out there, but highly recommend maybe a Kareem or a Wilt for that lineup. Besides that, you can can tell that this guy is a grinder. Kawhi there, David Robinson, he's got the level 40 rewards, and that Tyrese card is absolutely beautiful. It's a perfect lineup, man. But obviously, you can look at some centers, look at content that's coming out. Don't feel like you have to force yourself to buy any with MT right now. Just look around. Your lineup is very, very nice, but there's a lot of good centers out there you can purchase for that 1.5 million MT. Alrighty, here we have Jimmy Dimes. He's got Magic, Zach, Desmond Mason, Antoine Jameson, Nikola Vucevic, Russ, Dale Ellis, Thurl Bailey, Kat, and Mark Eden. Now, initially, Magic Johnson, fantastic point, bud. My only recommendation is potentially right now in this game, maybe upgrade the Russell Westbrook. For me personally, doesn't have a consistent jump shot. At least he doesn't have a consistent enough for this mode of the game, if you know what I mean. The game mode is changing quite a lot. If he works for you, perfect, that is completely fine. My only other thing is running Kat at power forward. For me personally, Kat at power forward, I tried it. I tried running Kat and Pau Gasol next to each other. It never worked for me, obviously because Pau was too slow, as I explained previously. Maybe look at investing in a really good, I think he's got 900K. So maybe look at getting an AK, maybe look at getting a Larry Bird, something like that, to put a power forward and then pushing that Kat, or choosing your favorite out of those two. Personally, I'll choose Kat, pushing him to the center and picking up a really good small forward, power forward. All right, and here we have Spiller, who is kind enough to give 10 subs in my channel on the previous stream. Thank you very much, Spiller. He's got Ben Simmons, Jared Sloan, Clyde, Antoine Jameson, Bill Walton, Steve Nash, I think that is, and Andrian Dentley, Ray Allen, Ben Wallace, and Carl Anthony Towns. Very good lineup, by the way. Very, very good lineup. First off, I'd recommend putting Ray at the shooting guard, potentially, just because Ray's a bit too small to play at small forward, like in terms of height. I can't remember off the top of my head how tall he is, but once again, if you're playing against like maybe a KD that's been put at small forward, it's going to be that mismatch, and he's not going to be able to defend him that well. And maybe look at upgrading Ben Wallace as well. I'm not sure how much MT you have, Spiller, but I'd recommend looking at maybe upgrading that backup power forward position, unless Ben Wallace works with you really well, but maybe push that Ray Allen down and look at upgrading your power forward. All right, guys, that's all we have time for today's video. I'm very, very sorry if I missed anyone. If I did, just let me know, and you'll definitely be included in the next one. I might do this in a few weeks or a few months from now, so make sure you guys are following me on Twitter. The links are in the description, and keep maybe turn on those noties if you feel up to it, if you don't mind the occasional tweet notification coming out, so you don't miss another chance to be featured in one of these videos. Thank you guys so much for the support on the previous videos. There's going to be a few more coming out for you out this next week. I'm very, very passionate about this YouTube grind. I'm trying my absolute best, and seeing you guys liking and commenting really means the world to me. So guys, make sure you comment down below which team you thought was the best, and please, I'm very sorry, I didn't want to come across as rude with reviewing any of these squads, but I did try my best. Thank you guys for submitting them all, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.